Welcome to Wood Gas Stove Science, where I attempt to learn the science behind wood gas stoves. In this video, I've built a glass outer can for the Vortex 5.4, so we can see how the air flows within the wood gas stove. Introducing the glass Vortex 5.4. As you can see, the outer can of this gas stove has been made out of a glass vase that was graciously donated by my wife, and I've drilled 4 fresh air intake holes around the outside. The inner can is simply the Vortex 5.4 can that we've talked so much about, and it's just inserted into the top. The lighting of the glass Vortex 5.4 is the same, and so are the parameters as all the previous videos. With around 1 cup of wood pellets and a splash, in this case a little more than a splash, of liquid heat from the yellow bottle. This stove came to gasification a little bit on the slow side, and I think it was because of the not so perfect fit of the inner can to the outer can at the top. Once the gas stove started to gasify, we got that same beautiful vortex flame that we've seen in other videos. The flame never got nearly as intense in any of these burns as the original Vortex 5.4, but that's due to the leaky area around the top can and the outer base. Notice that when a burning punk stick is placed inside the gas stove, you can actually see the gas pushing the flame downward. And in this view, you can actually see the smoke being pushed downward and then up the sides of the inner can as they make their way to the secondary air ports. Here you can see the fresh air intake working as it pulls the smoke into the stove. Here's another view of the air and smoke being pushed down out of the primary air ports, and then the smoke moves up the sides of the can towards the secondary air holes. You normally can't see the wood gas being pushed out of the bottom of the primary air ports. That's why I'm using smoke to allow us to trace those airflows. You've probably noticed in different clips on this video that the quality of the video changes quite significantly. I've had some major problems with cameras over the last few weeks, and that's why it's taken so long for me to actually get this video done. Here is a great view of the gases being burned at the primary air holes, and notice that when the flame is removed, how much brighter the flame at the top of the stove gets, and then how much it's reduced when you introduce the flame back into the bottom. Here's an interesting phenomenon. When I reinsert the stick into the hot wood gas rich environment, it reignites and starts to reburn the wood gas and the oxygen coming in from the fresh air inlet. This clip does a fantastic job about showing you how burning the wood gas that's coming out of the primary air holes affects the characteristics of the burning flame at the top of the stove. As you can see, when you put a small flame in, it does affect it pretty well. But as the flame under the can at the primary air holes starts burning more and more of the gas and gets bigger and bigger, the flame at the top starts to gutter out, and it really starts to get low. Now watch carefully at the reignition of this stick as it's put back into the can. You can see the wood gas stove flare up at the primary air intake and then shoot down to the stick. It's very cool. And here the stick is cool enough where it doesn't reignite, and shows the smoke and wood gas being pushed down from the primary air and then up the sides of the can again. In this view, there are some new wood pellets that are put in. Now, the new wood pellets smoke, but the smoke is not coming up. You can actually see that the smoke is going down. It's not coming up into the flame, but down in through the charred pellets. This view definitely shows that the stove is drafting downward. This next clip will be a demonstration on pyrolysis. Pyrolysis can be broken down into pyro, meaning fire, and lysis, meaning separating, which the word pyrolysis means the separating of material by fire. The true definition is a thermochemical decomposition of organic materials at elevated temperatures in the absence of oxygen. The gases produced by pyrolysis in wood are carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, methane, hydrogen, and various other vapors. Here I'm putting a punk stick into the top of the stove, all the way down to the wood pellets. If there is true pyrolysis occurring in the stove, there will be an oxygen-free zone between the top of the pellets and the bottom of the flame. So when I remove the punk stick from the stove, you'll see that everything that was below the flame is not burnt. If this was not true pyrolysis, that would have all been burnt all the way to the end. This next clip will show that if you burn enough of the wood gas coming out of the primary air holes, you can actually extinguish the flame at the top. So here you'll see that the flame underneath is burning bright and burning a lot of the wood gas, and the flame at the top just went out. Let's watch that again. Pretty cool, huh? Well, I hope this helps everybody understand the flow inside of a wood gas stove better. If you have any questions, please comment. And this ends Wood Gas Stove Science, where I build and burn a glass wood gas stove. Thank you for joining me. Goodbye.